Hi, welcome to the second video, the part two for this lunar eclipse that we're having in Aquarius on the South Node, conjunct Mars, squaring Uranus, opposite the Sun. Of course, the Moon's always opposite the Sun for a lunar blood moon eclipse. The Sun is on the North Node. So both the nodes are being activated. The dragon's tail, where the lunar part of it's happening, which is the past, which is kind of apt, and the dragon's head, which is the north node, where the sun is, which the sun is about the unfolding of consciousness and the development of the true will. And so we are getting a major ass kicking. Hello. What do you need to let go? Just do it. Just fucking do it. Like, stop hanging on, you know? Let it transform. It's gonna be to your benefit, I'm telling you. I'm telling you. It's good. Dark Goddess, she's like, all right, listen. Listen, it's time to like purge this shit. Whatever house this eclipse falls into in your chart, you gotta, you know, have the courage to release it and let life flow. Love is a river, drink from it, as Rumi said. That means that the water keeps flowing. You drink from it, there's more water. It's never the same river twice. You can't freeze it like that. You can dam it up, but you know why? There's water continuously coming down. You don't need to control it. There will be more. And the room you make now will be the space that something that is really conducive to where you currently are can come into the picture. It's upgrade time. It's time to walk through the door. Remember last week we got the Queen of, excuse me, the Queen of Wands. And she's about courage and about sovereignty and about saying, I am that I am, let's go, I'm ready, I'm just, you know, I wanna dance, I wanna sing, I wanna play, I wanna create, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do what's my true will to do and not really terribly interested in what is expected of me. This is a time of very potent magic. It's a time of blood magic where we have to like mean it and be willing to write it in blood. This is what it's what I'm here to do. This is what I'm moving toward. This is how I've learned from my past and I've done those patterns and I'm ready to commit and sign on the dotted line and sign the contract for the next step, for the next development, and go forward. Now, contradicting that or seeming to contradict that is the fact that Mercury is going retrograde the day of this eclipse. So not only is Mars retrograde on the dragon's tail, on the South Node, you know, stirring up all these old patterns and throwing it in our faces and saying, how are you going to take action in this respect? Do you want to keep going like this or are you ready to, like, you know, surrender and move on, you know, really move forward? Mercury's going backwards now. So, like, what do you do with that? There's a lot of mystery to this eclipse. And I think we have to be able to immerse ourselves in that mystery. And if you can, enjoy it. Love it. It's the occult. It's occulted. It is the moon occulted. Her light is blocked. And something very powerful from our past is revealed. And that revelation shows us where to go to develop a fucking cool ass future, you know? Don't you want that? Or do you just want the devil you know? Devil, you know, there's a seduction to that. There certainly is, because it's like, all right, you know, I know nothing will change. I'll have the same problems, but good. I already know this pattern. And you can do that. You can. Maybe. I don't know. You know, fate might have a different idea for you. I don't know. Some people do. Some people stay in the same patterns. We all know those people. Look at how that goes. Is that what you want? Maybe it is. Maybe it isn't. Maybe you medium want that, and like, but you know you should do something different, so you're gonna like take a little tentative step forward, and the universe is gonna shove your ass out there. I don't know. You know, it's all right to not be like totally sure of yourself, because this time is like very, you know, nobody knows this territory. That's the beauty of it. No one's been here before. You know, we've all, like, it's all new for all of us. So no one's an expert except your own inner knowing, your truth, your inner being, your heart of hearts, whatever we want to call it. That part of you knows, absolutely knows what to do, knows how to have sovereignty, knows what to do now, knows what kind of magic to do, knows what kind of intention to set. Knows where the love is, knows how to channel and connect to that love. And that love is what transforms the world. It may sound cheesy, it may sound saccharine, I don't know. But if you really deeply do your meditation, do your magic and connect, that's the bedrock that you'll always get to, if you're really doing your work properly, is that love is what it's all about. It is what makes the world go round. It is what creates the world. It is what nourishes the world. It is the life force itself. It is Eros itself. It is what makes our hearts beat. It is what makes us become incarnate. It is what pulls us back into the great beyond and makes us into something else. I mean, the universe is made out of love, and when we're connected to that, we have everything. And when we're disconnected to that, that's when we're fearful and fucked up. And yeah, like, we all get there. We all go there. We're all there maybe most of the time, right? Because we're living in this, you know, physical plane where we're on this, you know, we're like living in this, I don't know, Maya. We're living in this kind of illusion where we're separated, but that's kind of the game. That's kind of the trick. That's kind of the class, is to have that separation so that we can see ourselves. We're infinity looking at itself. It has to create a duality in order to be able to see itself. It's play. You have to remember that this is play. But at the time of this eclipse, it may not feel like play. It may feel like really serious life or death business. Venus is in a trine aspect with Pluto. That's some really deeply powerful, intense, intimate connection that's available. That may be uncomfortable if you're not used to being in that kind of territory and you're not really wanting to be seen and you're hiding something. It's going to come out anyway. Pluto's transformative. Venus is the goddess of love, and she really wants to be, she wants that intimacy. She wants that tantric connection. Because again, that's what creates the world. That's what creates. That's what creates. That's what makes life flow. And that's what this is about. Blood moon eclipse. Blood, life force, passions, blood, sweat, tears, salt, seawater, origins of life. You know? Connecting to that. Like, why are you alive? Find out. Meditate on it. I know I say that all the time. That should be like my little like byline. April's Arcana, meditate on it. You know? It's like, what does that mean? It means fucking feel it. You know? Sit with it. Allow it to surface. Meet it. Meet yourself. Tell your truth. A allow for things to be completely illogical and non-rational, especially at this eclipse. This is non-rational time. This is not logos. I was going to say logos. Logos logic time. It's not what this is. This is like, you know, this is allowing for something that seems not to make any sense and may seem to be completely contradictory to what you think you know, and what you think you know about yourself, what you think you know about the people you love, and what you think you know about the world, and allow this to maybe be true and see what happens and play with it and allow for that Aquarian possibility to unfold. What kind of new age might be created if I allow myself to let go of all these roles and all this bullshit and all these expectations and patterns and old ways of doing things and knee-jerk reactions and stereotypes and labels? What might happen if I was able to do that to the best of my ability and allow something new to emerge? What self might be there? What might be there? If you in your greatest, you know, your best world, what might be there? So I'm going to pick a card for this eclipse. This is a special one because this is in play for the next 3 months. So this is a very special divination that we're doing right now. We've got to let our genius emerge. Genius, genesis, origin, uniqueness. The medicine only you have to impart that no one else can do it for you. And there's a lot of challenge and a lot of change and a lot of radical change right now and a lot of awakening. And this is the time, lunar eclipse, this is something to say too. It is a hex breaking moment. This is the time to break the curse. What is the curse? If you thought you had a curse on you, and you've had the same freaking thing happen for how many times, and you've got, you know, this always happens to me, I must be cursed. What is that thing? And how can you send love there to break that curse? That's your work. That's your work right now. And notice where you're hanging on to it. Notice where you're hanging on to that curse, where that curse is serving your sense of identity. Your self-concept. I'm cursed in this way, and that makes me who I am. That makes me this kind of person. And if I let go of that, I don't know who the hell I am. Excellent! You don't know who you are? Fantastic! There's space for your true self to emerge. What's the true self versus a self-concept? Where do you draw that line? I don't really know until I know. Until I feel it. Until I'm there. And I have a moment where I feel truth. Then we know. We don't need an authority to tell us anything. We are sovereign over our own lives. We don't need somebody else. We don't need Facebook to tell us. We don't need YouTube. We don't need an astrologer. We don't need anybody to tell us that. We know. This eclipse, let it open up a portal to that gnosis. Through your body, through your heart, through the life force that's flowing through your veins, through your ancestral DNA, whatever the fuck you need to do. All right, so card. We're gonna pick our card. This is a special divination for the next couple months, all right? This is a big one. And we're gonna pick this card. That's not the right one. It's gonna be this one. I can sort of feel it, like when I have the right card, I can sort of like feel it here. I just feel like something's that one. This is interesting. So the Four of Swords, and I picked this last week for patrons, for where we're going and for the future. I mean, that's meditation, that's contemplation, that's rest, that's repose. What does that mean to you? When you see that card, do you feel relief or do you feel stifled? Do you feel alive or dead? Do you feel like, thank God? Or do you feel like, I don't want to do that? What might this offer to you? Four of Swords, even number of the mind, resting the mind, prayer, death, rebirth maybe. I know that's not the traditional meaning. I don't really care what the traditional meanings are, honestly. When we're doing these readings, it's not really that important. I mean, if you want to hang on to it, go ahead. But like, we're actually trying to do something, I think, that's, again, alive. And there's like, this person's in a sanctuary. There's a church. So that suggests to me, you know, a sanctuary and a holy place. And the image says peace, P-A-X, peace in Latin. So, peace. How can you find some peace amongst the turmoil of the blood moon or apparent turmoil? You know, maybe you're not in turmoil. It's fine. But where do you find the peace for you? What would bring you peace? What would peace feel like? Do you even know? Do you even know what repose feels like? Maybe you don't, you know? So there's a lot to explore there with this card. It's not the most glamorous card. It's not like picking, you know, like I picked the Empress, or I picked, you know, death, or I picked the Tower, or whatever. It's kind of like, wah, wah, you know, it's Four of Swords. Peace, okay. But peace, when you really feel that, so much can emerge from that place. It's like I finally have stopped berating myself, and I've finally given myself some forgiveness so I can relax. And then when we're in that relaxed state, that is the state of gnosis. That's when we really connect and know something. You know, we're not running around trying to gather information, try to gather this objective truth that exists nowhere. So that's the card. And I want to wish you lots of blessings for this full moon eclipse. It's a very powerful one. Whatever you're feeling is valid. Whatever comes up for you is valid. If you feel nothing, if you're like, yeah, I just breeze through this, that's valid too. You know, however this goes for you. Look at the house where it's falling in your chart to know a little bit more information about like where this shedding process may be going on, where this door is going to open, where you may need to re-evaluate, rethink, remember, you know, again, this reword comes up because, you know, it's Mars retrograde and then Mercury retrograde also. There's a lot of re-going over, and then the South Node is going back in time, back to our past lives. What have we brought in here from our past lives? What's in our DNA that still needs to be managed? I've given this a lot of thought just to share with you personally, you know, being here in Ireland. I went to an exhibition about the Great Famine here. I'm house sitting right now in Skibbereen, as I wanted to see the south part of this my new country, and haven't been down here before. So I wanted to spend some time and create and do some art. And the famine, you know, it's a very undertold story. Most, you know, I'm from the United States. Most Irish Americans really have no idea. They just heard that there was like this potato famine, but don't realize it was this like major, millions of people died, and it was very much caused by political choices on the part of the colonizers of this island. And Ireland was colonized for 300 years. I mean, this is like something that, unbelievably to me at this point, after living here for a year and a half, was not part of my understanding growing up in the United States. And my point, though, isn't to lecture on that, but to like share with you that I've been really connecting to my ancestors and to a lot of unfinished business that I'm feeling from my ancestors having left this island under duress because of this famine, because of this persecution, which is what it was. wasn't just no food. There was plenty of food. There was reasons behind the way that this happened. And then it's coming back here, and there's like this, there's like a lot of, like I say, unfinished business that now, you know, generations later, I'm in management of, you know, basically. And so that's kind of the way that this, just as an example for you, that's kind of the way that, this South Node Mars thing is sort of playing out for me. Is like, I'm just getting, you know, as a medial woman, I'm getting a lot of downloads about this and sorting all of that out, deciding what's useful and what is, you know, what needs to be released. And so it's, that's kind of part of my journey and my process that I wanted to share with you. So maybe you have something like that going on for you. Look at what's actually happening in your life to find out more. This is Freddie. You can't see him really, and I can't tilt the camera because it'll fall off here, but this is Freddie. He's a little puppy. I love him. He's wonderful. And I'm going to be going home to Gwitty in just a day or two. And he'll be back on camera. All right. So many blessings for this eclipse. And let me know what's going on for you. Share with that. And, you know, on Patreon, too, we have these discussions. And I'll be, I wrote a poem about that, about the ancestors and you know, kind of as this immortal, having this immortal or that my consciousness sort of is existing through generations, and I'm speaking as that consciousness that's been passed down through my body, my DNA, as both my soul and as the goddess herself, and kind of bringing those two things together in this poem. So I'm posting some of that on Patreon. You should be able to see that if you become a patron. I think it's apt for this eclipse. All right, so take care. Many blessings. Bye now.